In this class, we have a number of exercises and simulations that we use to represent the various processes and examples that we want to show you with our batch and event framing capabilities. And we're just going to simply review some of the simulations and the naming conventions for the tags that we've developed. All of our simulation tags have certain prefixes that will identify them so you can find them more easily when you're doing the exercises. Our pulp and paper simulation has a prefix of PP. All of the Cheesecake Factory tags have CCF as their prefix. EF represents our time or event-based framing example. And MB represents our multiple pie bats running example. All of the tags that we use will also have suffixes. These will identify them easily to you based on their function. The AP suffix means the active point. Some people refer to this as the trigger tag. BID and UBID are the batch and unit batch ID numbers. .PROD represents our product, and .PROC represents the procedure name. Some people refer to the procedure as the recipe. The pulp and paper simulation is a very basic simulation. It's got two lines. This diagram is showing line one. Each line has a chip screening device and a digester, and this is meant to represent a pulp and paper simulation. The Cheesecake Factory is a bit more complex. It's got three units, a crust mixer, cake mixer, and super cake maker. This will be seen toward the end of the course. We have something called the multiple pie batch running example. And this is an example where a batch spans multiple units. And each of these units, instead of just waiting for the entire batch to be finished, is loaded up with the subsequent batch while the material is moved from one unit to another. So for example, you see that batch number one, when it's done in unit one, it's moved to unit two and begins processing. Well, unit one doesn't want to stay down while the subsequent processing is going on, because batch number one has to move through two other units. So we start batch number two in unit one, and unit two is working on batch number one. Given one more iteration, unit number one is beginning batch number three, unit two is beginning batch number two, while unit three is finishing with batch number one. That is an example of multiple pie batches running, and that presents certain challenges as far as things like batch IDs. So we're going to take a look at that a little bit later in the course. Exercise 1 is going to require us to build digital states using the PySMT, or system management tools, to load those digital states that we'll need for the simulations. Exercises 1 and 2 are optional only in the sense that sometimes during the public classes that we put on, these exercises are already completed for us. If they're not already completed, you will be required to create these digital states. So I'm going to open up the PI system management tools. It's under the PI system menu in your start menu. And once I have opened that up, I'll make sure I'm connected to my PI server. My PI server happens to be called Train 56. And if you need to connect to your PI server, you'll need to use the file and connections and PI connection manager to either add or connect to your PI server. I'm going to go down under the points plugin and use the digital states editor. And you can see that there are some digital states that are already on our server. These are already simulation states, but not the ones we need. And the system digital state, as we teach people in PI System Manager 1, do not modify the system digital state set. It contains default values that might be required by some of our applications. So I'm going to select my server, Train 56. Yours may be called out by IP address. And I'm going to click on Import Sets from a File. And in the file that we downloaded and unzipped in the CD folder, you'll find one called exercise1_PIDS, PIDigitalStates.csv. You'll want to open that file, and when you do, you will see under the file preview all of the sets that are established. These are already established and set up. We don't have to do anything other than come down to the bottom and click Create Sets. that will create the digital state sets on the machine that we need for our simulations, and we can close. There's even no need to save because they're already in the system and saved during the import. Exercise 2 is going to ask us to build the tags using the Py tag configuration utility, or Py tag configurator, to create these simulation tags. Now, the tag configurator utility is an add-in to Microsoft Excel. So the spreadsheet that we give you to build these tags is already a spreadsheet in Microsoft Excel format. If I minimize my display and look in the folder that was unzipped from the downloads, I will find under CD something called Exercise 2 taglist.xls. Now, if you open that up, you will see a tag configurator formatted spreadsheet with all of the tags using all of those prefixes and suffixes that we talked about earlier in the description for all of the simulations that we have in this particular class. These are all the tags that are going to be built for the simulation, and you will need to build these on your Py server in order to do the exercises. One little note, some of the tags are digital or discrete tags, and they do require the digital sets to be built before you create the tags. So if you have not done exercise number 1, you will need to do that to build your states and state sets before you do this exercise. So I'm going to select add-ins and Py SMT, and I'm going to export my tags to my Py server. Again, if you need to configure the connection to your Py server, you can do that through the Py Connection Manager dialog box. I have my Py server selected, I have Point Class Classic selected, and the mode I want to use is Create. And I will click OK. And all of the tag attributes, as you can see, are being exported to the Py Point database. And when the entire process is done, I will have had all of the tags I need for my simulations created on my Py server. I can click OK and exit from my spreadsheet application.